Hey YouTubers, Xander here. Welcome back to Subnautica. Last time we did some exploring around the Auroran Mountain. Ran into some issues, got a lot of blueprints as per usual. And in this episode we want to focus on first expanding the base. So just kind of, well, I guess we'll also check this out too. Oof, that's loud. Here we go. So, let's see. I don't care about that. Well, I'll just pop that over there. We did fix the radiation, so pop that over there. We'll need to All right, that made it sound like it's not actually going to work. Okay, now it is working. Alright, more messages.
Aurora, it's Sunbeam. We've made orbit, and scans have found a landing site on the planet that's only rated hazardous. It's our best shot. We've sent you the coordinates. We'll be there in 2 days' time. Cross your fingers, the weather holds. And don't leave us waiting. Sunbeam out.
Man, I would love if this game had storms. It'd be so badass. There it is. I think I need creep vine for the
welcome aboard, Captain.
Fiber mesh. So let's go get some creep vine. Once we have the rebreather set up, we'll focus on collecting resources for base expansion. Let's assume it takes two creep vine. Oh, actually, let's eat some. Be good. Whoa! So, some updates. I decided on complete impulse to buy a new keyboard and mouse. The mouse was because of the spasming mouse wheel that was annoying the hell out of me. And the keyboard just because it was loud and I wanted a mechanical keyboard. Because I discovered that I was not using mechanical, I was using a membrane-based one. So, in theory, now that I'm using a cherry red mechanical keyboard, there should not be the annoying sounds of keyboard as often. I can already tell that, like, if I quickly press, there will be sound, but for the most part, this should, in when I'm being conscious about it, should alleviate the issue with that. Well, let's see, is this my titanium one? Yes, it is. Okay. Woof. Look at all these incomplete ones I have. I mean, I guess I could just look at it through the builder instead. Four titanium ingots, four lubricants in advanced market. Ooh, I have an alien containment. Nice. All the miscellaneous stuff. Well, they're not so miscellaneous anymore because the beds can actually be used to skip time, trash can be used to get rid of stuff, vending machines can actually provide sustenance. So, that's something. But now that I look at it, yes, I have the titanium, but I don't really have much else. Lithium and gold, lead and copper, but it's not exactly what I need. I need one more tooth as well. Okay. Let's just pop this all back in here. We'll go quartz hunting first. Quartz and silver. Woof. I'm going to take a wild guess and say that those are not silver-bearing trunks. So let's skip over to this kelp forest and possibly be a bit more successful. Huh? What the what? What? There's an invisible wall here? Alright. Wonder why that is. It's not even like I couldn't access it because the hanging stingers or whatever they're called. It was just straight up, no, I cannot. That is odd. Wonder why that is. Oh well. Looking for chunks. Looking for chunks. I'd like to build a scanner room, but it won't help. What about you? There's stalkers. Yeah, I hear ya, I just don't care. Again, that's not a real one. It's probably not. Yeah, what is going on? Have they changed the visuals on this section of the map and it's just not reflecting it visually for me? That's very odd. Oxygen. Yeah. Like I was running low on air, so I go deeper. Well, let's go head to a different kelp forest and hope that that may have a solution. However, if at any point I see a tooth dropped, I'm going to grab it because we only need three enameled glass. Well, we need three enameled glass for the observatory. Bonk. We need what, like five for the Cyclops, I believe. No, I don't need gold. Let's sit over here. No, that is not real. Is this a spot I already looked? Quite possible. Drop a tooth, please. there's the reclaimed water. Aha! Thank you. That's all I wanted. I mean, I'll have to do this again later when I want more, but that's besides the point. These are not going to be sandstone. These are not going to be real at all. Alright. Is the map breaking again? Is that what's going on? Is that what I'm going to have to deal with? Chances of this being sandstone, slim to none. Chances of this being real, even less. What is going on? Oh, come on, game. Don't be breaking on me. Finally got a second piece of silver. Fucking stalker, what the hell, man? Can't go in there, and almost dead. Alright. Where? Life pod. What the hell? Reef back in the safe shallows. Alright. I don't care about either of those right now. Alright, well, we got the tooth we need, so now it's just a matter of getting the quartz. Boy. Stuff in the game is being weird. Doo-da. I don't like what's happening. All the doo-da day. All the doo-da. I cannot sing at all. Doo-da. Oh my god, reef back. That looks weird and disgusting. Boo-boo. So I need to remember that I don't really need limestone chunks for any reason. Oh. That's not real or something. That's not real or something. Oh, I do need to remember that my health is a bit on the low side now. Why? I just said I don't need limestone. Why'd I go after limestone? Because I'm an idiot. That's why. Why would I even think... Why would that even need to be a question? Why is that not real? Why is that even a question? The game is broken. That's the answer. Why do I need air? Oh, because I'm human. Why is that a question? I'm not angry. You're angry. Okay. Over-exaggerated emotions aside, I'm wondering how permanent this issue right here is going to be. My guess, if it's anything like the other issues we've been having in the game, it is permanent until I start a new file. So the question is, how do I approach a situation like that? I don't want to start over again. I hate having to start over every week. Even though I don't exactly start over every week, it feels like it. Is it just chunks not loading in correctly again? Is that what's going on? That's copper. Is getting lag. Ooh. This be a crevice. Really? Let me in. Let me in. Oh, come on. Hi, bleeders. I don't care. What is... What the what? That's about to be, didn't need that at all. Where the hell am I? Whoa. I am in a way different location than I thought I was. Limestone. Bleeders. Limestone. Limestone. Why? I'm in the kelp forest. Copper. Limestone. Who would have guessed? Certainly not I. Okay, so based on the current... wait. Aha! Silver! So I'm going to, based on the current situation, I should switch priorities from, Instead of focusing on expanding the base, I think I might need to build the prawn suit first. And the reason for that is because I'm going to need a source. Holy crap. Of silver. If a bunch of these nodes are going to not be accessible, I'm going to need a lot of silver. So I should put the silver I do have towards a prawn suit in hopes that I'll be able to mine it from real sources or like chunk sources later on. Because I assume a prawn suit requires at least some amount of silver. Okay, that's not real either. A thermal vent. Now we're back in the safe shallows, so I guess we'll return to the life pod slash our sea moth. Limestone, not real, not real. Limestone. Hi. I mean, I know at this point it's just going to be limestone. This is Crash Central, so let's not go that way. Safe Shallows Reef back is Safe Shallows and floating? No, but close enough. Jeez.
How's our inventory looking?
Almost full! I wonder how that happened. And now it's full. Hop in Seamoth, head on back.
Welcome aboard. Woohoo!
Captain. Now the problem will be, where do I get silver nodes from? I don't remember. I want to say they're rather plentiful down lower? May have to head towards the dunes area. I don't know. Whoa, jeez. How did I miss that? Bonk. Home, sweet home. He was right, okay. So, Sans told me something I just remembered. And his comment was that when I exchanged the batteries to charge them last week, they disappeared because they were partially charged. Instead of actually, instead of having a partially charged battery appear in my inventory, instead they actually just completely vanished from existence. That's a bit of a shame. If I remember correctly, for the moon pool, advanced wiring kit, that's what I thought. So let's do that. Oop, wrong buttons. I'm so sorry, I didn't mean it, buttons. Okay, so we got the advanced wiring kit. We then need 4 titanium ingots, oh boy. That's an adventure and a half. I need more lockers. But I have those. Have I even been? What do I have in them? Nothing, and then like random stuff, right? Yeah, that's what I remember. Okay. Wah. Gold and lithium. We're gonna just shove all that in there. Gold. Lithium. And we'll just have silver, table coral. Ah, crud. Got so many batteries. Why do I have so many batteries? I need another locker. Isn't it like 1 glass, 2 titanium? So it's like 2 and 2. There we go. Another locker. Can't do it. Wait. Oh. Yeah. Sweet. We will throw in that, and that, and that, and, okay, that's fine, that, and that, And those. I guess those. And all of that will go in this one all the way over here. Because kaploosh, kaploosh, kaploosh. Splish, splash, taking a fucking bath. Go away. Alright. And kaboom. Kaboom. So let us see now. What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor in the morning? That should be enough for 2 titanium ingots. As you can see, I'm obviously focusing on the moon pool before I aim towards the prawn suit. The reason for that is because, I don't know, I want to place a dock both of them when needed. So now I need more titanium, go figure, and the creep vine clusters, which I'll go for the creep vine clusters first because I can also get titanium along the way and eat. Well, I didn't have to go far for that. To the point where I'm actually going to skip over because it's so close. Oh, oops. Nom 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 nom. Nom nom. I'm kind of debating, wondering how much longer I should keep the food challenge going, because at this point it's not even really doing anything. And I've mentioned this previously, where it just seems rather useless. And I still stand by that. So maybe I'll switch it up to the battery challenge sooner rather than later. Plus then, if I do that, and by that I mean switch challenges, I can actually start growing plants and stuff like that again, which was fun. I enjoyed doing that, and it would be like another room that I could have in the house and things like that. Can I eat these? No. Let us see, what do we need now? Do I have 4 lubricant? Yes, I do. Alright, all that's left is titanium. Let's head to the island first. We'll grab some bulbo tree stuff. Still got a whole obvious... Well, you can look at the timer and figure out how much time until the sunbeam arrives. So with that much time, we can easily get more food, drink stuff, collect titanium, and in theory be able to make a moon pool. However, I want to make it in a special way that I've never really done before with base building, and I want to create multiple stories again. And not just like, oh, ladder. I'm talking about the vertical version. I can't remember the name off the top of my head. But it's just a way that, I don't know, make it a little bit more interesting. More three-dimensional than what I usually have been doing. Now, if I remember correctly, there was actually Bulbo stuff up here. That was always bypassing. Yep, and there we go. Om nom 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 nom. Nom. So our water situation is back to almost top. We are on the complete opposite side. We'll get back at approximately 10 minutes. What we might just do is start making our way to the sunbeam instead of heading back to base. Ooh. However, there's one thing we will return home real quick. The reason for that is a power cell. I'm looking at my energy levels right now and I'm a bit hesitant to progress further without having a backup source. First though, I remember there was those two, three, four, five. All right, wow. One little, two little, three little sources of titanium. Five little, six little sources of titanium. So it's not that that's, it can't fit in our inventory, it's the fact that it doesn't exist properly. Neither does that. That's not even a thing. That's limestone. That's a sand shark. That's not real. Alright. What about you? Are either of you real? You're real with gold. You're real silver! Yay! My inventory's full now because I grabbed those two. Also, look at all this metal salvage. It's a smorgasbord. Hidden right around the... Son of a bitch. Game, quit teasing me like this. Please? I beg of thee. I've never been so excited to see silver in my life.
Oxygen.
It's interesting how it didn't give me an indicator about the 30-second mark. At least to my knowledge. Obviously, I was still paying attention to it regardless, but...
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I think you guys get the idea. Another reason I'd kind of like to place the moon pool down deeper is because by doing that we can also create a closer source towards a thermal vent and be able to use like the power transmitters and things like that in order to safely... basically another source of power while still having the main structure of the base over here. We have 4 silver, which is a very good amount, I'd say. I'd like to grab 1 power cell. We'll start making our way over. Grab creep vines along the way. Possibly stop by the life pod. And that's why. I wanted to stop by the life pod because I am so low on health, and unfortunately I'm not getting health regeneration from having high amounts of food, like high levels of food and water, because it's difficult to maintain that when I'm only eating bulbo trees. Ooh, we could stop by the Koosh Zone. That's an idea. That's actually a very good idea. Whether or not we have the time to do that, I kind of doubt it, but we could probably grab it on the way back. Just a quick source of food. And drink, I believe it heals both equally. So make sure we come to a stop, because if the ship crashes into us right now, or Seamoth crashes into us, we are actually just straight up dead. Oh, thank you, past me. Oh, these are two that I already looked at, maybe. Maybe that's why I have that. Anyways, with 5 minutes remaining, we should head towards the mountain while grabbing salvage. I don't know why I'm being so sing-songy today, but I apologize, question mark? Invisible wall. Caught that out of the corner of my eye and I wanted to investigate properly. Now, are we about to hit nighttime or is this a solar eclipse? I'm guessing that's just actually nighttime. And that doesn't exist. We have 4 minutes remaining, so now we should probably speed up a little bit. There's a thermal vent nearby. Yeah, it's nighttime. Okay. Oof, fuck. I knew there was a thing there, I just didn't expect it to curve in such a way that I would, like, really get in our way. I thought if I were just simply turn or go at an angle, I'd be able to avoid it just narrowly, but that was actually not the case. That doesn't exist. That is limestone. I may have already searched these before. In fact, I'm fairly certain that I have. Okay. I guess we'll just have to ignore it for now, keep going, especially because we're actually still quite a distance away from the landing site. And while we do have 3 minutes, that is possibly cutting it slightly close. So, yeah. I don't know what I expected that I would have wanted. Woohoo! Well, that kind of sucks that it's going to happen in the middle of the night. Though I don't believe I've ever seen it at night. Most of the times when I see this, it happens during the day. Interesting. La 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 la. I've been told that there's been a lot more of the purple artifacts placed around the map, including, like, in the mountain itself, specifically near, like, the peak. There is apparently one, so, Man, that looks beautiful. Kind of reminds me of, like, I don't know, Mars? Like an extremely close-up version of it? Here we go. We are going to see the death of the sunbeam in the middle of the night. And yet it says that we cannot stop it because we are infected.
Attention, patching in a local broadcast from the sunbeam.
I don't believe it. There's someone down there. Aurora, survivor, we have your PDA signature. I don't know how you walked away from that wreck, let alone survive since then. We'll be happy to bring you on board and hightail back to Federation space. Stand back. We're approaching the landing site now. Breaking atmosphere in 5, 4, 3. What is that? No, the red spike. From the planet.
Right as the sun rises on a new day, it begins with the death of the only crew that would have saved us. Tragic in its own way, but we already knew that was going to happen. Let's do a quick search, see if there is another artifact that we can find floating around, or, well, which shouldn't be floating in theory. Guns returning to its original state, I assume. That was a cave crab. What the hell? The heck's going on? Oh boy. Well, scratch my ideas, jeez. Alright, fine. It's gonna hurt, yep. That's so weird. Ouch. There he is. I was like, I know there's a Reaper down there. So forget my dreams of exploring the mountain in hopes of another purple artifact. So weird. Hi there. Having problems, dude? Guess not.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
That was a bunch of audio glitches. Well, guess we'll grab some more titanium on our way back. Possibly some more quartz as well. We used up most of it making the lockers. Ah, the underwater island. So many memories. I had such a beautiful base down here. Although it wasn't oriented right in the slightest, it still looked pretty. And that's what matters. This should be the way to the... Huh. Maybe not? Whew! Those guys scared me for a second. I thought that was, oh, this actually is the dunes. So I should be afraid. I thought... I saw those, reef bags and mistook their tendrils as Leviathan. Oh my gosh. Like the mouth of a Leviathan. Dancing scrap. Chunks? Any sort of sandstone, perhaps? No? Yes? No? Yes? Question mark? Nope. Yes? Nope. Yes? Nope. Yes, son of a bitch. Yes? Nope. Yes? No. That moment when you lose your sea moth because it's right in front of your face. Let's head back. Safe shallows? Where am I? Whoa. Oh, this is like that mini patch of safe shallows. Like, barely anything, like, does not actually constitute as a safe shallow in my eyes. Inventory full? Well, who on earth did that? Okay. It's time to head on back, expand the base, and look into building the prawn suit. I guess we will expand the base first.
Whoa.
Minefield of floaters and reef backs. We didn't stop to get koosh crap. there even going to be enough room for all this? Probably. Yeah, okay. Gold doesn't go in there. Gold goes all the way over here. Even though I really need food right now, I guess I'll do that. Let's grab some kelp real quick. Now with the still suit, our water situation is more or less taken care of. The problem now is actual food, since we can only really acquire food from the Creepvine and Koosh. Let's see, we want those, that, those, and the... ease. An idea. Oh, interesting. Does that mean I... Okay, there's no way to rotate it, so it has to go that way. Not particularly happy about that, but I shall live. Let us grab more titanium! We shall further expand out this way. Possibly one more. Uh, I now need to actually construct reinforcements. Can't forget about that. Let's do this. Time to put the lithium to good use. We'll plant them upstairs, I guess. This will be more than enough for quite a while. Yeah, with a hull strength of 58 now, I think we'll last a bit. Titanium reservoirs are running a bit on the low side, but I think we'll be fine. Ooh, do we actually need to build out one more? It's quite possible. Multi-stories, I guess. Oh, I can't actually connect anything. Okay. Yeah, let's just do that instead. Whatever shall I do? Oh, shoot. Actually, what will I do? No more titanium. Did I actually use all my titanium? I did. Okay. Well. Bit of a problem. I guess I'll dump all that for now and then go grab some more. Shouldn't be too hard. I already know that there is a plethora around this area. And again, can grab more creep vines. Like, look at that. Look at all this. Well, I probably should be grabbing the creep vines first. Inventory space reasons, obviously. That would make too much sense, so I don't feel like doing it. Huh. I am actually, like, slowly losing food as a result of this. Interesting. I believe I was at 47 the last time I ate creep vine. So I have to either eat it more frequently, or obviously just creep vine alone isn't enough to maintain my hunger status. Which is kind of interesting. Back to our expanding home. We're almost out of time, but I want to at least get the observatory and moon pool set up beforehand. Oh crud. Can't quite do it without actual titanium instead of just metal salvage. Woohoo! There we go. That's quite a bit of titanium, if I say so myself. Should be more than enough to get down. Problem is now is that I can't quite see. I think we're almost to where I'd like to be. Just a few more should do it. Hi. I didn't bring the stuff for it. And I'm out of titanium. Alright. That is so janky and kind of really terrible. But I think I guess it will serve the purposes that it needs to. So let's just grab a little bit more metal scrap. I will also risk eating more creep vine. Never mind. Oh, come on. Thank you. Oh, wait. I already have silicone back at base. That's fine, actually. Woof. Hi. I mean, it's titanium. Completely intentional. I left those there knowing I'd find them eventually. Oh, come on. Ooh, hello. Sure, actually. You too, leaving you behind was intentional. Okay, yeah. What's that? I don't know what this oxygen thing you speak of is. Woohoo! Back to base, a little bit longer. We'll have moon pool built, the observatory, just the base itself will be expanded. Like, now that I think about it, technically just building out for an extremely long way probably would have saved on titanium. I just would have had to run that direction a really long way. And I don't know how I feel about that. Come on, stop clicking wrong buttons. I'm gonna grab that silicone wall. That's going on. Make ourselves a new knife. Now that's a knife. Let's do this. That'd be fun. I just realized I could do. Alright, that's it. I could put a hole in the base near the bottom just by using my knife. And let it slowly flood all the way up to the top. I don't know why, but that crap kind of stuff I always found entertaining. Okay. You know what? I'm eating that. Because holy crap, this right now is being ridiculous. Ridiculous, I say! Fine, I'll save two. Boop, boop. Nice.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Alright, so the plan is to hopefully build the moon pool. Oh, yes! Oh, that's perfect! You bastard! With one per- You jerk! You almighty prick! With 1% left on the frickin' thing, I needed to exchange the battery, and it fucking vanished on me because of that bug that's going on. You fucking jerk. There we go. Fine, let's exchange this too while we're at it. Yep, it vanished. Who would have guessed? Alright. Okay, so maybe I can't do the one battery challenge right now just because of the fact that... God dang. Alright. Oh my god, I'm gonna lose all my batteries just from that stupid glitch. Back down here, finish the 1% of the moon pool. I can't believe that. Like, at the same time, that's really funny, but damn it. Is that silver right there? That might be. Oh, I don't like that it's facing the wrong way. Alright, hang on. going to attempt to see if I can rotate this in a way. Is there any way to turn it around? Doesn't appear so. That's mildly frustrating. Just because I would have really liked to have it face the other way so I wouldn't have to turn around every single time I leave. But it's fine, I guess. I'll just have to deal with it. Like a big boy. I guess that kind of works out with the whole, like, climbing out of it, too. I guess. Ugh, that's frustrating. While I could build it, like, the other side, just it fits more conveniently there. Unless... I don't know. Oop, wrong buttons. Deep. How much titanium? I got plenty of titanium. Oh, boop. I am going to move this to the other side, multiple reasons. Man, this is a long episode, but so worth it. Not really, but whatever. Ooh, actually. There's no real way into this thing, is there, from there? God damn it. Okay, so it has to be over here. Unless I wanted to put it, like, directly in front, but even then, that's not really an easy spot to get into. Alright. However, I can push it back a little bit more. So I guess that'll work. And if that's the case, I can actually... push this back one more spot as well. And then go like that. Whee! Head on in. Now this thing will start charging. Yeah, nothing in storage, and apparently that causes glitches, so that's good. Just turn right here. Sadly, it's an eclipse, but let's do this. Do I want a lap counter? Nah, I want a desk. And I want the comfy chair. No. Oh? Woo! Can I get around it? Easily. Can I sit in it? Easily. Does the view look nice? Not particularly. Let's actually get rid of the desk. There's no reason to have a desk. Let's just have the chair. Here. Yeah. There. All right. That looks a little bit better. I guess. May have to just lower this at some point, even deeper. Alright. But let's head back. So we have our moon pool now. And we can use this to get all the way back up to the top. Cool. Alright. I'll just store the rest of the titanium. We'll probably build a large room on the left side, and it'll probably be like two stories or something, possibly even going down further. Or we might actually just replace the observatory. Ooh, we'll replace the observatory with a multi-room and then go like a couple floors down with that. So we can have like a living area, and I'm probably gonna drop the knife only food challenge and then have an actual farm down there, and then possibly another third floor, and then from there it could branch out a little bit more and have the observatory so it's closer, we can actually see more, things like that. And then now if we go back to the X, the right will be the moon pool. Forward will lead to the multi-rooms, and to the left we could put the scanner room. So I think that's a nice way that we can set up the base. And so, yeah. So we'll work on building the prawn suit and expanding the base some more. We'll probably possibly build a second moon pool after building the prawn suit, just so we can have them both docked. And if that was the case... Ooh, if that's the case, we could have a moon pool on either side of that X instead. From the direction I'm looking right now, the right one could be for the prawn suit, the left could be for the sea moth. I like that. Okay. So build a prawn suit, build a second moon pool, and just further expand on the base. I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I guess I'm sorry about the invisible walls that I couldn't control. I guess I'll see you next time.